Here? Hallelujah. Make sure we are here. Thank you, Jesus. It's an amazing time to be here once more to worship God with you guys, to have a fellowship. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for this time. Stay with us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Love as you love. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There is no other God. I thought I went down, come close to knowing you. Now I am yours and you are mine. Our love is the secret that I find. I'll spend forever in the pleasure I found looking to your eyes. Give me treasure that I hold. Now that I've tasted of your goodness, nothing else will satisfy. Give me Jesus, give me Jesus.
Give me Jesus, give me Jesus, you can have all this world, you can have all this world.
Can you say that today?
Give me Jesus.
You can have.
You can have all this world. You can have all this world.
You can have all this world. With you, I see my reflection. When I lock eyes with you, I feel your affection. I love to get lost in you. Cause you're my obsession, the way I lock eyes with you. And all I want is you. Jesus, the way I lock eyes with you, I see my reflection, the way I lock eyes with you, I feel your affection, I want to get lost in you, you're my obsession, when I lock eyes with you. Let's look to Jesus. Oh, and all I want is you. And all I need is you. And all I see is you. It is you, Jesus. Like a fire, you come in like a flood. I don't care what it looks like, I'm so in love. So come in like a fire, so come in like a flood. I don't care what it looks like, I'm so in love. I don't care what it looks like, I'm so in love. Coming like a fire, coming like a flood. I don't care what it looks like, I'm so in love. And all I want is you. Part. Can we sing all together? All we want?
All I want is you. All I need is you,
Jesus. All I see is you. It is you, Amen. You can take a seat. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So just change for me in the screen right here. The screen. Yeah. So it's a pleasure to be here one more time with you guys. Pastor Kelly now have the you know, but I don't have the mic. I don't think the cords can go there. And if I stay here, I can use the stream. You know, I'm still in the beginning. Pastor Kelly already have, you know, everything set up in his mind. I'm still, I can say, you know, actually we all are under construction because God is building us the way he wants, you know, us to be. We was formed in sin, but we want to be, you know, like him. You want to be like Jesus is. So I think like the songs I was trying to sing today, I was trying, you know, talk about today, it's actually the songs that made us to look to Jesus, because it's so easy for us to get lost. The situations we have been, you know, we seen around the world, it's like the devil is really trying to take our attention from what it really it's important for, you know, the vain things. And you know, God put on my heart to talking about this. What has stopped us? I want to drink just a little bit of water. I'm going to talk to Pastor Kelly, like, next time he can come talk a little bit, I can rest. Hallelujah. What has been stopping us? You can go, actually, you know, we can go to the next, and I say this. What has been trying to stop us? Because we can have someone, it's really there. It's going, it's not going anywhere. It's still. And we have another kind of people. They are trying to walk. They are trying to proceed, but that is something try to hold him back, to try make he doesn't go anywhere. So to the next, I have Genesis, and God, you know, I have some other situations that came on my mind to talk about, like, you know, the guy who was needing to be healed by the foot, like he doesn't walk it, so he is still. But on this case, I'm gonna use Lot's wife as an example today, because I think it's, you know, has some things I can take from that. And the Genesis chapter 19, the verse 26 said, "But Lot's wife looked back, and she became a pillar of salt." So, if I ask you, what do you think that could make Lot's wife look back? So the history here, it's like God was about to destroy that Sodoma and Gomorrah. That's how I say in Portuguese. I don't know if it sounds like in English. But God was about, you know, the abomination of that city was stink, was bad. And we are seeing the same situation happening in the whole country today on the planet, okay? So, and God said to Lot, like, "I'm going to take you out." He sent two angels in his house and say, "You know, I'm going to take you and your family out. So when you are out, I'm going to destroy this city. I can't destroy this city while you are still there, but I need to take you out first. So the salvation, the grace, it's coming. So even we have an evil world, this grace, it's surrounding us. wherever we are going, wherever you go, the grace following you. And there, they knew, because, you know, they have the situation that the men want to have a relation with the angels. And, you know, the angels took Lot inside of the house and make those men blind. So, you know, they were seeing the miracles happening already, you know. So as soon as the morning came, the angels told them, like, we need to leave now. And they was taking time to leave of that situation. We need to leave from there now. And they was holding on that city. So the situation was so badly that the angels had to pull them and hold them. Come on, we need to go now. You know, it's like, come on, why are you still stuck in there? So since before they leave of the city, they, you know, was already having some situations that was holding them on that place, that we could have some in our lives too. And that's I will try to say some today. So when the angel told them, you guys gonna leave, and as soon you leave the city, don't look behind, don't look back, don't look, just go ahead, look ahead. And, you know, I think Lot's wife, she's like, okay, I passed it. Maybe she think like, I already passed the limit, you know, of Sodom and Gomorrah. Maybe I can look what's going on. So as soon as she looked behind, she became a pillar of salt. So this is, I can bring to you and to me today, like, what could hold us in the place and let us be stuck in something. So I'm going to try talk this today. And I think this is so serious that even Jesus, in the next slide, is going to say in Luke chapter 17, he used this, and he said, remember Lot's wife. And if you look before, you're going to see, you know, Jesus talking about a lot of stuff, and even saying when we are, you know, paying attention on things on this world today. So we are living in a world that we see the devil try take our attention to the things he's trying to, you know, to take attention to the things that's no important. And we, if you don't look at Jesus, if you don't look to what really is important, we probably can be stuck in. We can be holding a place. Because Jesus is saying, look at me. When I lock my eyes with you, I see my affection. The song we sang here today. When I lock my eyes with you, I see my reflection. You want to know who you are? Look to Jesus. Because like, we can see today the people go to the social media and they, like, let's say, I'm not using me as example, but I like, oh my God, look my shirt, look my, I'm going to post today. Oh my God, look how Marcio is. He has a haircut. He, you know, he painted his hair. He has a earring or something nice. He want to show that. But on Monday morning, he doesn't want to show how sad he is. Because something happened on his weekend, or something happened on his work, or because of forgiveness need to be happening on this life, and he's holding that, and now he's not want to post how sad he is. He should be like that, right? Don't you think like me? We should be showing everything, but we don't do that. Because we want to show the exterior. We want to show what's outside. But the only one knows what's going on inside of me and you, and he's Jesus, and he's knowing everything we are passing through. Hallelujah. So we go to the next stop. I think I already asked you, but what could have made Lot's wife look back? If you remember, when Abraham was before Abraham and Abraham. You say Abraham? Yeah. Thank you. Abraham and Lot. So they have so much sheep, they have so much animals, and they have to, you know, divide one of the other. And then Abraham said to Lot, okay, you pick the place where you want to go. And Lot, he looked to the best place. He looked to the place that looked green, you know, prosperous place. And the eyes, his eyes say, I want to go there. It looks amazing. I want to go there. So probably that city was a very rich city. They had so much stuff. Maybe Lot's wife, she had so much stuff, properties. Maybe, I don't know, what she was looking behind. What could make us to look behind today? Maybe our past, maybe situations that you made, you know, you repented today. I think if I ask you, and maybe you agree with me if I say this, I wish to born, you know, to have my 17 years old back today with all the wisdom that I have, and maybe a lot of mistakes that I did, I don't think I will do it again. But today, you are who you are because of the mistakes that you have it and you learn it with it. Remember when you was doing like math, 2 + 2 = 5, and then wrong, it's 4. Oh my God, let's go again. Because we learn when you do wrong. We learn when you have mistakes, but we need to learn and go ahead. We cannot be on the same mistakes. We need to keep going. So the next slide said, what can make us look backwards? And what can paralyze us? So I put us, because before I say loss, and I say to you, I ask you today, what could you make you stop? What could you make you be paralyzed? And I think, as God know me and know you, everyone has a different thought inside. And maybe everyone has a different, you know, situations that can make you be still right there and don't move. So the first thing I put, it's like the things of this world. The things of this world is the next slide. The things we have in the world today, do you think, you know, we look today the world like, I was so mad when I see, you know, the election in Brazil. I was so close, you know, when you pay so much attention in something you want to make happening. Like, it's like a team, you know, you have your team. You know, like Eagles, oh, they lost, we'd be so mad, you know what I mean? But, you know, when you have something in your life that you desire that happening and doesn't happen like you want, you know, I went to one of my clients on Friday, and when I came at her house, she was, like, mad. I said, why are you mad? Oh, I was waiting for a long time to buy a ticket for a singer. I don't know the singer's name, but when she went to the website, her computer went frozen, and came back, it was sold out. I said, oh my God. She was so mad. So we have some questions in our life, like, why, you know, some bad things happening? Why the people stealing others? Why the people killing others? And this is some stuff of the world can try to stop us if you keep pay attention. If you keep look at the news today, this is gonna, I'm telling you, the news today is one thing it might be stopping you. With you see some tragedies, you see some crimes, you see like some situations. But one thing I tell you this, Jesus is in control of everything. And maybe when the situation is passing from you and it's not happening like you think it should be happening, it's okay. He knows that. He knows what's going on in your life. We need to release that it's our Father and we are the Son. You know, He's taking care of us. You know, we felt and the daddy comes, I'm going to take care of you. But why I felt? Sometimes God say, the father say like, don't run. Stop running. You're going to fall. You're going to, boom. What I told you, come here. That is going to take care of this. You know, sometimes, but he's on control of everything. He's knowing what's going to do. So when you start talking in things about this word, I couldn't leave the phone of this situation, because as I see my house, and I think you might know, you know, maybe someone that you see, I'm not saying your house, I'm just using my house, okay, with my kids. If you leave, they can take the phone from the time they wake until the time they go to sleep. If you leave, they do it. And that we, as a father and as a parents, we are taking care of the life, right? You have to work, you have to cook, and you cannot be 100% of your time look what your kids is looking. And one of the things the devil is trying to stop you to do the things you shouldn't do, it's the cell phone. The cell phone. I can say the computer, I can say the cell phone, I can say the TV, because it's taking your attention from what you should do. Let's say, tomorrow is Saturday, David. Tomorrow is Saturday. So, and then your mom say, can you cut the grass for me outside? Saturday. I say, okay, mom, let me go. So maybe you do your phone and you stay all day looking, you know what I mean? When you see, it's already 12. When you see, it's already 3 o'clock. Actually, that's funny, Pastor. The time is passing so fast that I think the people, they're gonna leave the ornaments for, you know, hanging a house, like Christmas stuff, St. Patrick's. I think they're going to put in a living room, because the time is passing so fast. They say, the tree's already up. It's almost there. It's coming, the Christmas again. You know, you just have, it's going so fast. I think they're going to leave it like St. Patrick's stuff. You know, the people, they hang the Patrick's, the ornamentations. Oh, my God. The ornamentations for everything, because the time is passing so fast. So we can go to the next slide, and I put some situations, and I say, like, the cell phone can stop us, the life is the struggles, the afflictions, the cell phone, the diseases, the finances, the cell phone. So I really put 3 times the cell phone, because I think, you know, we are really, you know, some people are really addictive on this. I saw one video. Someone in an apartment called the police because the girl was screaming. And the police came and went to the house. What's going on? And the mom said, it's just because I took her phone. She was on Facebook and TikTok all day long. I took her phone from her, and now she's screaming for the building, the whole building know that. And the police talked to her. You see, you need that? You see, that's no good for you. So, and then the police was with the mommy, you know, and looked like they forgiving each other after this, everything. But it's so badly, and we see, you know, this happening. I think it's the kids very addictive. The word sometimes doesn't come out. The next slide say, John 16:33. I have told you those things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. We need to look at Jesus. We're going to have those situations passing. The struggle is going to pass. It's going to try. But you know, Jesus, he overcome. And with him, look at him and know what he's desiring for us. We will overcome with. Hallelujah. So John 5:19. We know that we are children of God and that the whole world is under control of the evil one. So What do you think the devil is trying to do? And we as a parent, we need to be close to our kids, because these words belong to him already. He's taking control what God is letting him do it, because God has control of everything. I heard someone say, like, when God wants to do something evil, he calls the devil, and he do perfectly, you know, but he's under control of everything. Nothing's going to pass his control. Nothing. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is. His good, pleasing, and perfect will. We need to be conformed for what God's want. So if you see the form, for us, form in Portuguese, we see shape. Do not conform. Do not get the shape of this word. You know what I mean? So when you take this word conform, if you see in Portuguese, it's like a shape. And the evil, the devil, he's already have his mind what he wants to do, you know, and he want to make the shape. And we need to look at Jesus to not look at those things, because we don't have to worry about that, because God has a will for me and for you, and he will made. I believe so. Hallelujah. So the past things, that's some stuff, you know, we sometimes hold a lot. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here. As I said in the beginning, how many of us maybe, you know, passing situations that, like, I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to do that, but I have this on my statement, on my records. But I thank you so much for Jesus, because he's saying for me and for you. But when you don't look at Jesus, we look to the people around us that they are not looking Jesus. And they come and say for me, oh, why are you so depressed? Oh, it's because of this. I know. It's bad. Take Tylenol. Yeah, tomorrow you're going to be better. But if they come for me, for you, we're going to say, this is going to pass. You know, God can take a control of this situation. You know, I've learned, you know, like, how I have to use the God's word on any situation. Because if God made me to be on somebody, the house, or, you know, seeing people in trouble, if they come to me, they will need to listen some words of God. Amen? Are you feeling of the words of God in your heart to share with the others? Because we are here for this time. God prepared us. It's preparing us for this time. You know, Miss Shannon, when you go to bring your food and they come crying to you, you say, Jesus loves you. Because one day, me and my wife, we went to a store, and one guy was sitting right in the front of the store. And they said, I'm going to go to, you know, maybe give some dollar to him. And I said, hey, man, how are you? I'm fine. Can I ask you something? Yeah. Why are you sitting here? Oh, man, I don't want to say much. And he said, I had a kid with my wife, and we lost the kid, the baby. And after a couple months, she died too. So I have no more reason for leave, so I'm staying here, just thinking and thinking. He's really stuck. If you see that chains of the picture in the beginning, that chains is holding him right there. The life is still running. And we need to continue our life. And like this guy, Many other people are stuck because of different situations. And God, it's taking me and you to have the words for those people that are needing to listen a word of life. And we have it because Jesus is a person. And he is inside of me and he is inside of you. And the grace that we have, it's going to overflowing from us and it's going to fill them. And then they're going to be enjoying the word of God. We need to look at Jesus. We don't need to be sad because someone is sad. We need to have the faith that, okay, you're dead. Okay, you're going to jump right now. Come on, wake up. Stand off this bed. Let's go. We go walk. We go sing. We go jump. I don't know what you're going to do, but I don't want to see you anymore on this bed. Wake up. God has made us for this time. We are the end. I believe that we are the last generation that we're going to see Jesus come and take the church. We will see it. I believe it. And we the devil is trying to get the most he can. And we need to take from him the most we can. The gates of the hell will be not closed for us. We're going to go and, bah! Come on, gates, get off. I want to go and grab him from the hell. You will be alive. You're gonna have eternal life. You want to have what I have? I have Jesus. I know it's a process. But we need to keep talking because the devil want to stop us. And we're going to look to Jesus and Jesus say, keep going, keep going. Hallelujah. Yes, this is a call to mind and therefore I have hope. We need to bring to our memory what is hope. I sometimes have my wife, she always, I'm thankful for my wife, and she's always with me, and she's saying, you need to believe in Jesus. You need to believe in Jesus. You sing Jesus, and you need to believe what you're singing. You say about Jesus, but you need to hold on this name. It's a rock. You know, I was thinking about, like, where are you, your... It's an anchor, right? The boat, when they stop and they don't want to go anywhere, they have an anchor. Anchor, right? Anchor. Where are your anchor at? Is with you in your boat? Because, if you try and hold your anchor, you go, if you're winding, you go, you might be over in the water. But if you have a Jesus as your anchor, you're going to be still. And I always remember when Jesus came and walked in water. Say, oh my God, I need to be deep. My ankle need to be deep in the sea, and then my boat's going to be still. But Jesus was walking in the water. Doesn't matter. If he walks on the water, you can go with him. He's your ankle. He will not let you fall. Fear and anxiety. And this is the most today, I think, might be on the top list of the people suffering, anxiety and fear. And I have these words for you today. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you, in God, whose word I praise. In God I trust, and I am not afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? We don't need to be afraid. We need to look for Jesus. Praying, look at his words. We need to look at Jesus. The next one says this: do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. So, we need to believe on this word. And I'm telling you this, maybe when you talk about anxious and fear, we always want to hold this. that chain and that heavy ball, sometimes it is inside of us. We want to hold that, and we don't want to share this with anybody. But the better thing is, when you have something in your life that's holding you, make you heavy, share with someone. Call your pastor. Call your mother. Call your wife. Talk to her. Because we try and like, hold up. I don't want to share. I don't want to make. No, we need to pray together. We need to put this out. I don't want to have this. We need to cut this chain out in Jesus' name. I don't want a chain. Jesus' name, Jesus breaks every chain. The chain of the past, the chains of the anxiety, the chain of fear. We need to believe in Jesus. We need to believe in the one who we are preaching to. Because he is our salvation. He's, you know, the Pastor Kelly, they made this circle. You know what that means? We want to be together. We don't want to be just us, stage people, and, you know, no. We are the same. We have the same blood. We have the same Jesus. The same DNA that came from Jesus is in me and in you. If they do the test, the angel come and let's do the heaven test. Oh, my God, you are the same Father. Actually, the all population are because they have the name of that shape like as a cross, Pastor Kelly. We all have the lamina, and is the shape of the lamina is in our body. It's like a shape of the cross. That's amazing, right? We all have it. We born with. God thought of that before we're born. So we have to, you know, ask help for each and other. First things first. This first things first. Before I read this, I want to say this. You know, before when I started to come to the church, I was like, I have to worship my God. I have to play guitar. I have to sing. But Pastor, I was using my minister as a first thing ever in my life. And this cannot happen because if I have someone that I don't forgive, everything I'm doing, it's nothing. If I have my wife that I need to love and that, you know, I'm asking God to work on my life every time, every day more, to have a better relationship with my wife and to have a better relationship with my kids. Because if I'm not loving the one that's close to me that I'm seeing, how am I going to love God that I'm not seeing? If I'm not loving my brother, my friend, my neighbor, how am I going to love God that I'm not seeing? When I put first thing first, I was meaning this. Let's see if this is the... Yeah. Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all those things will be given to you as well. When you put the God's desire first, as me as a man, I have to love my wife as Jesus loved the church. That is not easy. But you know, that's why God is saying. And then I say, okay, wife, I don't... Okay, you stay home, I go worship God. And she stay home. I'm not doing the first... I'm not seeking the kingdom first. If you have your offering, you leave on side, go forgiving your brother, and then you come back with your offering. Remember this? Yes? Because, you know, it's so easy for us to think like, oh no, our church is better, my minister is better, my work is better, what I do is better. I don't care about you. I don't care about you. And God's make us to be together. When you do your first things first, that means what is really the main thing you should do it. In my case, I have to love my wife. I have to have a relationship with my wife and my kids. And then, you know, I'm aware worshiping God, because if I'm doing His desiring, all these things will be given to you as well. Everything else will come. Like she always say, I already told you guys, she says this, when you read the Bible and do what the Bible said, the magic happens. You know, it's like, bah, boom. Why? Because you're doing what God wants you to do. We need to focus on do what God wants to, not what we think it's better. Because depending where we look into, if you look into the news, you look into somebody else, or if you look into your heart, you might be deceiver. But if you look to God, if you look what God wants, you will be on track. Maybe you don't look at exactly, oh my God, Lot, he has the better place. Look where I'm going to. Doesn't look so green that way. But God say, I'm going to give this land to you. Look around. This is all yours. Look around. This is all yours. And after Lot have to came out, and God destroyed all that city, Sodom and Gomorrah. We do not seek the Lord as a first help. Yeah, go to the next. I started to read, Pastor Kelly, the Colossians chapter 3 was the three first verse. I want to invite Mr. David, if you could read for me the whole chapter. You can, you know, I don't want to read for you guys. So, yeah, you have with you. Can you read for me? I want to read the whole chapter of Colossians chapter 3. You can come up here, please, to read in the mic. And then we will end for this.
So we got Colossians chapter 3. This is the ESV. But if then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, what is earthly in you: sexual immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming. In these you too once walked, when you were living in them. But now you must put them all away: anger, wrath, malice, slander, and obscene talk from your mouth. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have put off the old self with its practices, and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge after the image of its creator. Here there is not Greek and Jew, circumcised and uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave, free, but Christ is all and in all. Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience, bearing with one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other, as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, I keep reading, right? To the end of chapter. Wives, submit to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. Fathers, do not provoke your children, lest they become discouraged. Bondservants, obey in everything those who are your earthly masters, not by way of eye service as people pleasers, but with sincerity of heart, fearing the Lord. Whatever you do, work heartily, as for the Lord and not for men, knowing that from the Lord you will receive the inheritance as your reward. You are serving the Lord Christ, for the wrongdoer will be paid back for the wrong he has done, and there is no partiality.
I think this was a big resume what I tried to say. When I read that, I was about to use the two first verse, and I was keeping reading. I said, I think I have, it's going to be so much stuff to put in the screen. I said, I'm going to ask someone to read. And if you have something in your heart about forgiveness, let it go. Let it go. I'm telling you. Maybe the person that you didn't forgive, they even know about that, but you still, if you still have it, and that you are holding this heavy thing with you, whatever you're going to, let it go. You can call her, you can call him, forgive, and be free of this thing. In Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, I want to thank you for this time that, you know, you have spoken my heart about this type of word. And I ask you in Jesus' name, keeping talking with us during this week about this, to look to you. And I want to be stuck. I don't want to look behind. I want to look at you, Jesus, because you are my salvation. You are my salvation. And thank you for everything in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Pastor, you want to say something? Let's sing the last song then. Hallelujah. Stand in your feet.
So much sorrow, so much rain in this desert. I pray for rain. So I surrender all my fear.
I can trust you. I know you are here. I will remember your promise that you will never forget me. I will remember your promise.
Forsake me.
Lord Jesus, we want to thank you for this time. Help us to look at you, Jesus. Help us to look to you in all situations we have been passing through. All in difficulties, forgiveness, anxiety, fear, struggle. In Jesus' name, we ask you right now, in Jesus' name, give us strength. Give us strength, give us healer. And we thank you, Jesus, because we know you are on the control of everything. Everything is on your control, Jesus. Thank you so much for everything. And we all say, amen. Have you all a blessed week in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.